back in Italian classes with Amita. Today's topic is how can I get admission in a college or uni in Italy and what is the procedure? I made a little slideshow to show you guys what are some requirements for a bachelor degree and a list of what could be a possible course that you can take if you come from another country. Let's go and take a look to a site that I am going to show you.
How can I get admission in college or uni in Italy? What is the procedure? Requirements for a bachelor's degree. The requirements for a bachelor's degree at an Italian university are that you must successfully have completed upper secondary studies, have a valid certificate that proves that you went to school and you qualify for higher education studies in your home country. I requisiti per una laurea in università italiana sono che devi aver completato con successo gli studi secondari superiori, avere un certificato valido che dimostri che sei andato a scuola e ti qualifichi per gli studi di istruzione superiore nel tuo paese d'origine. Is education free in Italy? Education in Italy is free for children of all nationalities who are residents in Italy. Italy has both private and public education system, but everyone has to pay for the university, citizen less and international eligible more. L'istruzione in Italia è gratuita per i bambini di tutte le nazionalità residenti in Italia. L'Italia ha un sistema di istruzione sia privato che pubblico, ma tutti devono pagare per l'università, i cittadini di meno e gli studenti internazionali un po' di più. Private universities. Private universities usually charge higher tuition fee, as in every country, compared to public university, and most of them have the same fee for both European and non-European students. Le università private di solito applicano tasse universitarie più elevate, come in tutti i paesi. Rispetto alle università pubbliche, la maggior parte di esse ha le stesse tasse sia per gli studenti europei che per quelli non europei. The average tuition fee in private universities range between 3,000 to 35,000 euro per year. Le tasse di iscrizione medie nelle università private variano tra 3.000 ai 35.000 euro all'anno. Public schools are government schools, and if you move to another region, you can start again your studies from where you left them. Le scuole pubbliche sono quelle governative e se ti trasferisci in un'altra regione puoi ricominciare gli studi da dove li hai lasciati. Private schools are good, but you don't know if their certificates are valid in all Italy or out of this country. Le scuole private sono buone, ma non sai se i loro certificati sono validi in tutta Italia o fuori da questo paese. International students. Unfortunately, international students are not entitled for free tuition education. However, scholarships and bursaries are available for students if required, which can be offered through the university or via the student's government. Sfortunatamente, gli studenti internazionali non hanno diritto all'istruzione gratuita. Tuttavia, borse di studio sono disponibili per gli studenti, se necessario, che possono essere offerti attraverso l'università o il governo dello studente. What course could I take? For example, I put some examples over here, a list of some courses that you could do. For example, what course could I take? I put a list of examples that you can take. Informatica, computer technology, grafica, graphics, turismo, tourism, fotografia, photography, arte, moda, art, fashion, and all the other in the list. Now, let's go and check out the site that I've talked about, Centro Formativo Provinciale, which varies according to the province you live in, where you can possibly complete your studies if you come from another country, or even if you did the grade 8 in Italy and you want to complete studies in a easy way, you can go and check this site. Let's go and see some features together. So here we are on the site I was talking about, Centro Formativo Provinciale. And if we swipe down, we can see that there are many options as Dopo la Terza Media, Formazione Adulti, Formazione Aziende Professionisti, Apprendistato, Annunci di Lavoro. As we were talking about adults, we go on Formazione Adulti, and as swiping down, we can see that there is double check of what we want to do, so Formazione Adulti again, then Ambito, which is which course we want to do, and then Sede, which is location, so I can choose Brescia, which is the city, and then Cerca, which means search. And as a result, you guys can see that I got some results as Contabilità e Procedure Amministrative Livello Base, Paghe e Gestione del Personale, Contabilità e Procedure Amministrative Livello Avanzato. As I got the results for one course, I can get many other results for other courses. For example, now I can click on one, and you guys can see that they give us all the information about this course, in how many hours we can complete this course, the description, the goals, and what do we need, and how old do we have to be to do this course. Let's do another example. For example, from here, Ambito, I can choose Commercio and then search again. And as a result, they gave me these. For example, Agente e Rappresentante di Commercio, Agente d'Affari, Somministrazione e Vendita di Alimenti e Bevande, and other courses. So if you click on this one, you can see that for this course, you need 130 hours to complete, and you have to be 18 plus to do this course.
I hope that the video and the site that I showed you were helpful. For now, bye-bye, and don't forget to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe.